Okay, was that kind of a swap and trade thing today? And mostly gun-related stuff. I was trying to sell some guns, but probably gonna end up with more guns. But anyway, that's just the way it works out. But I bought this big box of gun parts. Between this and this stock here, I paid $30 for this thing. So just gonna go through it here. I haven't gone through it that much myself, so we'll go through it together, and you guys can decide if I got a good deal or not. And some of the stuff I'll try to figure out what it is. There's a few things I'm not really sure what the stuff is, so little screws and little gun parts, I'm not sure what they're off of, but if somebody knows, it might be helpful. But so we'll go over this first stock off a 1889 Smith's Reuben, or what's left to it. But it's got the magazine. The lower trigger guard and stuff is missing a couple of screws and stuff. But I figured the magazine was worth $5, so that's all I paid for this. So I figured it was worth that. And then all this stuff here was all like $25. The guy just wanted to get rid of the stuff, I guess. So, this here, like a magazine off a 1910 Ross. He didn't even know what it was, but it's probably worth something by itself. Just go through everything one at a time here and move it to the side. So, trigger guard off a, let's see, a number one Mark III, I guess this one would be. Believe. Yeah. There's several of these pieces of four wood off of a number ones. Some of the pieces cut off or broke off. There's like four of those. They're kind of nice to have because they break once, like, well, most of them are cracked anyway, but they're kind of fragile. There's that. Number one Mark III bolt with no bolt head. I don't know what this bolt is out of. I have no idea. It's like a 22, but I don't know if it's a Mossberg or what it is. But, seems kind of huge for a 22, but kind of weird. Anyway, that's there. There's like a trigger guard off of something. I don't know. It's like an aluminum one, but I'm not sure what it goes on. Let's see. It's like all kinds of butt plates. It's either that steel one or the alloy one. There's my magnet. Don't know. Anyway. That's those aluminum ones they made. Feels really light. And the normal brass ones. Either like number ones or mark or number one Mark threes or number fours. Steel stamped ones, I think. And this is off a, it's like a P14 or a P17, I guess. It's one of the aluminum ones, number fours. Brass infield butt plate. And the steel one, number four. Number four. For Mark One, because we got the triggers on the trigger guard, trigger on the triggers on the trigger guard. And that's number four Mark One as well. I'm not sure what that is. Sight. So that's sort of the Mark III, the stamped one, goes up to 1,300 yards. It's pretty good shape though. I think it's, I don't know if it's missing a piece or not on the back there. There's that. Number one Mark III back sight. the thing for the oiler, I guess. I think we're scooping the oil out. Part of a sling swivel, half it's cut off for some weird reason. Another one of those things, so I'm thinking of something for... There's anything in the wood that's... I'm not sure. Maybe something for Lee Enfield, I'm not sure. Where that one's. That's the thing that holds the wood on. I don't know if it's a Lee Enfield or what, but it's been cut. So a lot of these don't. A lot of them you can't get them on or off without taking, like, the sights off. So it's got, like, it could be a Mauser one, too. I don't know. And there's a bunch of these. It's like a number one Mark III front sight. Number four front sight. Bunch of those. There's the end of a barrel with has the sight still on it. So those are the lugs. It's a pretty good barrel, actually. That's a, was a two groove, I guess. This here, I'm not sure what this is. It's out of a, what's that? How was that Savage 22 that has the handle that you can push it right through and lock it shut, or I'm not sure. I kind of think that's what that is, but it's got this piece and a coil spring or something, and I guess the ejector or what that is. I don't know. Anyway. He had it there. I didn't know what it was. He didn't know what it was. And he just said, here, take it. I'm like, okay. Somebody might know what it is. Somebody can... Somebody need parts or... make a deal or something. Okay, that stuff's going everywhere. I gotta put it in a bag or something. Let's see. Number one Mark III front sight. Number one Mark III front sight. I didn't know this was in here until just a couple seconds ago. It's the trigger guard and the breech block out of a Martini Henry. So that's a pretty good score. This has got the firing pin, the spring. Most of it's there. Just missing the locking screw. I'm just beating on the firing pin a bit. Still got the trigger spring and stuff in there. Got a Norman Mark III bolt is actually, I don't know, wait a second, I thought it was complete, but it's not. The firing pin broke off, or what? No, no, it's just cocked. Yeah, it comes out. And the locking screw doesn't go in for some weird reason, but seems to be all there. Extractor works. Another butt plate. Lots of those. I think that's one of those weird old deer licenses from 1974. These weird ones in the old days, they had to like bend them around and hook them together somehow. That's what that is, I guess. It's a bolt out of a, it's not a number four bolt because they're round on the end instead of being square. So they're good to have. A lot of times you get butt stocks for guns, they don't have the screw with them. I don't know what this out of a shotgun of some sort or something. And then we got tons and tons of butt plate screws. Let's see. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, holy crap. 15. They're good to have, though. It's got you flat on the back, which I kind of never seen a flat one before, I don't think. Don't look like it got beat that way either. They're good to have. A lot of times you get butt plates too, and you don't get no screws with them, so. And that's like the. The number one R3 has this little plunger under the front nose cap, I think. That's what that is. Just a couple of those. Screw for something, I don't know what that is. Not sure. It's a lock washer. I think that goes on. That's the for the buttstock bolt. Maybe. I'm not sure. Another steel butt plate. A couple of those lock washers. And that's the stacking hook, I guess, on the front for number one or number four. Another number one nose for front sight. That's off the front nose cap on them. Number one Mark III, I think that's the one that goes up from the bottom. I think that's what that one is. Couple of those, three of those, another one of those bloody things. There's a bunch of them there. And that's part of, I think that's part of the peep sight for like, off a Cooey. Has a little eyepiece that goes on it. The model, was it 78 and 82 had those. And there's a bolt head for the number 7, because it has the offset for the 22. Rimfire. Cool. Random wood screw. Took somebody trying to make a peep sight out of that. I don't know what that is. Another one of those things. Elevator off some sort of sight that's all beat up. Another stacking swivel. Oh. Front sight off a. No idea. Like a marbles or one of them ones. That's the remnants of a charger bridge off of number 4, I guess. Looks like they filed it off. Or hacksawed it off. Don't know what that is. Random wood screw. There's a bunch of these. Okay. Camera crapped out. There's multiple cross pins for like number 4 back sights. There's 1, 2. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That's part of the safety spring. I think that's the bottom part of it. They just cut it off. It's an action screw out of something. It's not an infield. I don't think it's too long. I don't know what that's out of. That's anything Lee Enfield related. And there's a safety off a. It's a number 4, I guess. Yeah, number 4. Part of the safety, anyway. And there's some of these little. I think that little short pin, that's the one that holds the. On the bolt catch inside, the place where it is. There's a little part that supports it. I think this pin comes through and it kind of supports one side of it. I think it holds the. The mag catch or something as well. I think that's what that pin is. No, it's not a pin, but there's more of these friggin' things too. And then. And that's the screw for the back part of the. Like this part. Back part of the trigger guard that holds it on. That's what that screw's for. And some 22 shells, some 30 carbine casings. Piece of a $20 bill. Hey, look, see, look, 20 bucks. Yeah. See, I got my money back almost. That's everything. 308. There's a little. Well, that's not. That's a. The ejector? I think it is. Well, I don't know. It's kind of short. I don't think it is, but maybe. And there's the other part of the safety. the part that jams into the part of the cocking piece, I guess. Those pins. What's that? What's the same for the sight? That's the back sight one. Got the end busted off. 38 watt cutters. I'm still loaded. I've seen better days, though. That screw head there. Looks like it has screw goes in there. I don't know. I'm not sure. A little spring. I don't know if that's actually. Maybe just out of a. I don't think it's out of a pen. That's for that. It doesn't seem heavy enough for the. There's a spring that holds the back sight of the number 4. I think it's heavier than that. But anyway, that's more or less everything, I guess. It's a pretty good mob, a pile of stuff. Random stuff. So anyway, what do you think, guys? I think I got a pretty good deal. I think I did. Stuff. Anyway, talk to you later.